question of the week. Harley, got some bugs under the mulberry tree here. Bugs dropping all over me. Harley, you talk a lot of shit about Gabriel Cousins. You say that Gabriel Cousins promotes an 80-10-10 high-carb, low-fat, plant-based diet for reversing diabetes. In actual fact, that's not true, Harley. Gabriel promotes a high-fat, low-carb diet. Well, I've got nothing personal against Gabriel Cousins. I think he's a great guy, and this video is my comments, my critique of some videos that Gabriel Cousins put out there. I'm just saying what Gabriel's saying, man. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you where the confusion lays, because it looks like Gabriel's saying both things. So here we go. Check it out, and you make your decision. And if you're more confused afterwards, then you just got to listen to what's working. All right, check it out.
So I've been looking at this in terms of diabetes and kind of gotten into a whole field that's emerging. And what we're seeing is a high carbohydrate diet is the least healthy diet.
Interesting. Now listen really carefully what Gabriel is about to say. Listen.
The diet that works the best is a high fiber, high carbohydrate, low protein, low fat diet. That's the diet that works the best.
Did Gabriel Cousins from the Tree of Life just say a high carbohydrate, low fat, low protein diet works best for diabetics? Nah, I heard wrong. Let's play it again.
The diet that works the best is a high fiber, high carbohydrate, low protein, low fat diet. That's the diet that works the best.
What did Gabriel just say?
The diet that works the best is a high fiber, high carbohydrate, low protein, low fat diet. That's the diet that works the best.
And just one more time, I had a mulberry stuck in my ear. Ah, that's better. Waxy.
The diet that works the best is a high fiber, high carbohydrate, low protein, low fat diet. That's the diet that works the best.
So I've been looking at this in terms of diabetes, and what we're seeing is a high carbohydrate diet is the least healthy diet. Two bananas, you're close to your fructose limit. So let's get clear. And what we're seeing is a high carbohydrate diet is the least healthy diet. So let's get clear.
The diet that works the best is a high fiber, high carbohydrate, low protein, low fat diet. That's the diet that works the best.
Isn't that interesting? It looks like the healthier diets are diets that are going to have high and natural fats and low in carbohydrate.
The diet that works the best is a high fiber, high carbohydrate, low protein, low fat diet. That's the diet that works the best.
Fascinating. So let's get clear. Does Satan exist? The answer is yes. Satan is an angelic force created by God and totally in control of by God. Well, the truth is that Satan is an angelic servant of God, not a rebel, an angelic servant of God, and the role of Satan is to create judgment so people can evolve spiritually. So there's a very profound and real role, and it comes up in different ways. Now, Satan existed before the Adamic race. It's all part of the creation thing. And of course, there were seven civilizations before the Adamic race, Lemuria, Atlantis, and so forth. So that's not new. What happened at the time of Adam, there was a place where Satan, instead of being outside of us, became part of our consciousness. So that helps us evolve. How? Because we're always struggling with the Satan, because in the yogic tradition we call bhakti, it got rasa. So what happens when you, this is, you know, no personal God, there's a missing of rasa. And so these enlightened beings, even after enlightenment, are still doing pujas. That's a very important principle. And at the same time, in Kabbalistic tradition, there's only God. Fascinating.